I'm ready when you are, bud.
My name is Chris Paul, and this is my introductory speech. First, I'm going to talk to you guys about my birth. Not the gory details, but a little bit so you guys should know. I was born to Heather Cole. She was 21 when she had me, and she had me at Guard City Hospital, which is, I don't know if you guys are familiar with Guard City, but it's right down by the kind of Westland, Detroit area. So she had me on March 9th, 1999, and surprisingly, unlike most people, she was the only one on a birth certificate because I did not have a relationship with my father, which seems like kind of like taboo to most people, but to me it's pretty much normal. Like, so, the meaning behind my name was very mom's teenage years, she was really rocky, kind of rebellious, not in a good state of mind. And she had a lot of friends just like her, as I'm sure a lot of people that I'm looking at right now do. And one of her friends' names were Chris, and he was like gang related, bad, but he was a good kid, as like the rest of my family did, and they all said that he was really nice. And he got sent to a group home, and he was murdered then. But my mom continued to remember him, and think of him as a good person that she thought he was, so she decided to name me after him, which I kind of think it's bad luck, because he got murdered. I don't really want to be named because he was murdered, but
you're still here, man. Hang strong.
My family background, that's another little rocky subject. Most people that I'm looking at right now, like your age, mom, dad, couple of brothers, sisters, not in my case. I was pretty much raised by my grandparents and my aunt and uncle, which a lot of people automatically think, oh, that's sad, or I'm sorry, which you should not be. I don't want you to feel bad for me at all, because if anything, it made me more of who I am than what I was raised by my family. And as I said, with my father, I didn't have much of a relationship with him at all. Like, we don't talk from each other. And my mom is in and out, kind of. So I pretty much write her off. Doesn't really matter to me. Doesn't bother me. My ethnicity. Another rocky one, right? My mother is both Caucasian, and my dad is Puerto Rican and Black. And being born into like an all-white family can kind of start off as rocky, because not that I'm really proud of it, but my family was a little bit racist before I came along, which I kind of learned to not understand racism, but not take it so personally, because some people are like standoffish or think bad about their race. It's usually because they don't know them. They don't think of them as people, they think of them as a race. But, like, my aunt and my mom both had biracial children, so my grandpa was very iffy about that when we first came out. But as we grew, he was learning that we should overlook it and we should love us, so he did, and now my whole family pretty much can't say anything because I can't really change who I am. That's the most to me. A lot of people would say sports or family or other things. What means the most to me is my friends. Because there are things that does happen in my family. People come and go. Most of my friends have stayed. And I can say all of them have because they haven't, but the ones that count do, like Chelsea already went through. So this picture from her, that's Seth, Cameron, Erica, Jordan, Chelsea, me, and Megan. Me and Cameron have been friends for a few years, same as Erica. Same for Jordan. Me and Chelsea have been friends since about 6th grade. We've had our ups and downs, as she knows. It's been pretty rocky. And me and Megan have been pretty good friends for a few years now. And no, this is not some of all my friends, because I have a lot more than really close friends. Haley knows her brother's one of my good friends, but it's hard to get a picture with him because it's a picture. Saves life. And same for newborn.
All right.